Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, good evening, and welcome to the Candlelight Processional. Tonight's presentation is under the baton of conductor Christopher Confessori.
Thank you.
Liberty and Epcot's Candlelight Processional.
Oh, tidings of comfort and
gentlemen, please welcome this evening's special guest narrator, Kurt Russell.
Evening, everybody, and welcome. I'm not sure if you know, but Walt Disney began the tradition of the Candlelight Processional at Disneyland. And for over 50 years, literally millions of guests have enjoyed the Christmas story, the traditional carols, and especially the glorious music of the holiday season. So now, I invite you to sit back and enjoy our magnificent orchestra and singers. Are you ready? Then let's begin. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin who was betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you shall call his name Jesus." A decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. and all went, each to his own town. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. Same region, there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were filled with great fear. The angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all. Unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord." suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill towards men. Shepherds said to one another, let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. And they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. And when they saw it, they made known the saying that had been told them concerning this child. All who heard it wondered at what the shepherds told them.
Oh,
After Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose in the east and have come to worship him." And when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
Sweet.
of the birth of Christ has been told and retold for over 2,000 years. About 200 years ago, in a small church in Austria, the organist Franz came to Joseph Moore and said, "Father Joseph, the organ is broken. We will have no music for the Christmas Eve service." Later in the day, as Joseph made his rounds, he visited a home where a baby had just been born. And he thought about the birth of the baby Jesus. He was so inspired, he wrote a poem. He went back to the church and found Franz. He said, "We can't have the old organ, baby, we can have a new song. You can play the guitar." Franz said, "Father, I only know three chords. Then make a song with three chords." Well, Franz hummed and strummed. Soon he had composed the most beautiful and beloved of all Christmas carols. It's a gift bestowed upon us all during this special time of year. Tonight, people all around the world mark this joyful season with heartfelt sentiment. As we each treasure our unique holiday traditions of family, faith, and culture, let us join together in celebrating the birth of the blessed babe in the manger and rejoice in the universal message peace on earth and goodwill toward men. Joy to the world! unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, the Prince.
That's awesome.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you. I have sincerely enjoyed being here with you. And I hope you've enjoyed this Candlelight Processional. I'm coming back. Hey, however you celebrate during this time of year, may you and yours find the love and joy and peace of this holiday season. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Take a kid.